Can you see this?
This is my
อาจารย์ลืมเปิดไมค์ป่ะครับพวกผมไม่ได้ยินเสียงเลย
ไม่ได้เปิดไมค์ค่ะไม่ใช่ไม่เปิดไมค์ค่ะเปิดไมค์ค่ะแต่ว่าครูไม่พูดเท่านั้นเองรอเพื่อนเข้ามาก่อนกำล
ไ
ั
ด
ง
้ครับ
จะรีคอลข้อสอบอยู่ค่ะนี่บอกจนที่สุดแล้วนะเนี่ยโอเค so in this examination as someone asked me privately right there will be 10 questions in this examination and it will take about 3 hours so I have 10 questions and there are two parts right according to topics, right? Main topics. The first one is about the array, right? For the first one, the first question will be about the one-dimensional array, that is easy. Second, it is two-dimensional array. Okay, this is about the matrix operation. A matrix operation. Okay, in this examination, if I didn't say anything, you might have to start with the input, right? So, for example, if I want you to do the addition for two by two or three by three matrices, right? You need to start with the input. You have to know how to input two-dimensional array and then process according to the matrix operation, and then you need to print out, you have to show the output for the matrix multiplication. So this is the things that you have to keep in mind. Even I didn't say that you have to start from input, you have to start from there's no input. So I will have I would like to say that you have to keep in your mind that you need to show input, because for each answer will have the score, okay? And there is only one question about string, okay? And the fourth and the fifth, like this is about the standard deviation. You may have to apply the array. Okay, in the past, maybe you know about the loop, right? But you didn't know about the array in the module one, but module two, you have known array, right? You have to make use of array in order to input the score, and then you have to calculate for the standard deviation. That is not difficult, right? You have to find the what we call the average or mean, right? And then you have to use some mathematics function library, okay? And yeah, for standard deviation, I will give you the formula. No need to remember or memorize the standard deviation formula. And the last one is a histogram, right? Do you know histogram? It is like you have to input you need to get the input from keyboard, right? As maybe integer, and then you need to count the number of duplicate numbers and keep it into another array and then try to print out the histogram or the number of hits for each number. Okay, and for the functions you have to, okay, these are of the possible example of the questions, right? Starting from function with no return or void function with a return value, function that use pass by value or copy, function that the argument will be passed by reference or pointer, and the last one you will have just only one recursive function exam. Okay, so in the exam, maybe you have to read the question carefully. Okay. So do you have any question? If not, maybe I will start to review you about array. Okay. If you have any question, or if you want me to say about a particular topic again, you can chat, you can type in the chat box. Okay. So for this example, suppose you okay, because we are going to have the string as well, so you need to know how to manipulate the string. But string is anyway, it is like the array of integer, right? So from this example, if you declare string, maybe you this one is the way to declare string, right? You can put the number to show the size of the string or the number of the storage of the string, or you didn't say anything, that's okay, right? Because you are going to to initialize the string, right? CPE can UTT something like this. But in the exam, maybe you have to get the input from keyboard, right? You need to scan F. Okay, so for this example, it's like, okay, when I show you the visualization, so this string, how many string we have? We have 10 slots for the character, right? For this example, and then this one, when you go next, and then CPE hyphen KMUTT and backslash zero will be initialized to this string variable. Okay, and for array, you have declared the number of the storage, right, to be 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be initialized to this. And if you want to access, or you want to change the value of array zero is the first element of array, so you can also do that. So that's not the problem. Okay, shall we? Okay, maybe I think all of you know about how to set up or how to initialize array of both integer or array of character, which is string. Okay, so suppose I have integer character like this, array of integer like this. If I want to show it in reverse order, how can we do? Okay, please help me to change this one. Okay. Maybe we need to. We saw array, right? Fine, right. If we want to initialize result to be all zero, we can just this, right? Even we just show only one zero, right? It will be initialized all element in this result array to be zero. It will be set to zero and then for loop, right? If you want to integer I form 5, right? But actually it is 5 minus 1 because the array will be minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? This is 4, so this is minus 1. Okay, and then I less than. I still greater than or equal to 0, right? And I minus minus, right? Suppose I want to copy 5 to 0. I mean, sorry, the 5 into the first element, 4 to the second element of an array, right? What shall we do? So result I, right, is equal to array I. Maybe if we want to be confused, maybe we can start I from 0 and then this one to 5 and I plus plus. So now the result will be, yeah, result 0 will be from 4, right? So I will be 4 minus I. Because I start from 0, right? And the first element of result will be used, or we use from the 4, right? The index 4. But this one we have to minus I because we want to reduce the number of 4, 3, 2, and 1, and 0. Okay, so here we can have this. Okay, and then visualize execution. Let's see. Okay, now string will set to CVE CAMUTT. Oops, too last. Sorry, again. Oops. Next. CAMUTT and set array to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then result. This one, this statement will set our result to 0. Can you see that? Uh-huh. And then for loop, right? I for loop. Now, array 4 will be, array 4 is 5, will be replaced to a result 0. So, 5 will copy to this, and then 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, and that's all. So this is the result. Mm-hmm. Okay, makes sense. You think you can follow this step, right? Please press 5 so I can know that you all know about this before I will move to the next one. Good. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, good. Okay. So if you understand now, I want you to go to one more step further, right? One more step further to you have seen that this is CPE KMUTT. I want you to reverse this thing. Can you do this? Okay, from this code, right? This piece of code, please perform reverse something. You can imitate this. Okay, but you have to it has to be reminded that at the end of this string, it is the null value or backslash 0. Okay, so maybe you have to declare the result string. Okay, RASSTR. Okay, and I may have to set it up to 10 character. Okay, please try. You can copy this and then try to do this one to change, right? Sing. And this one result sing, result sing. And then change. Okay, this is enough or not? I'm not sure. This is 5, this is 4, this is 10, this is supposed to be 9. Can you see the result? Start with \0. Okay, if you are trying to copy this piece of code, right, you will see that there are some problem in this. So anyone in this room, what will be printed out if you are trying to print out result string here? What will be printed out? มุมัดอาซาเซ่นอตติ้งสุดทางเซ่นอตติ้ง any other result yes nothing right on now string why because when you are trying to print out this string \0 will be found first and then the printf function will stop and no, nothing will be printed out. So please debug and correct this piece of code. Okay, when I run this again, and then last, you can see that for the print output, there is nothing has been printed out. Okay. So we want to shift T to 0 index, right? So What I have to change will be 1 to 0, so I add more I minus 1 and then visualize it. Okay, I just add up minus 1 here. Okay, now T is coming. T T U M K C E E P C, and then okay. It is lucky that the last one will be placed by the index of before string C, which is backslash 0. So backslash come out. So I want to say that this one you need to be okay. Maybe you just want to print. You just want, it might be easier that you will consider only from 0 index to 8 index, 0 index to 8 index. So this one will be starting from 2 8 index, right? So this one will be from 9 to 8. Okay, and then the last, you have done that the last character of this string will be nine, right, is equal to character backslash 0. So when I run this, next. T T U M K two and C, right? C will be the last character to be placed, and then resulting index 9, which is this, will be backslash 0. Okay. Okay, I copy the code to this 2 line. Okay. And I think I have to move to the two-dimensional array, right? For two-dimensional array, right? For if I start with integer matrix, okay. If I want to, okay, me, I will start from the easiest one that is 2 by 2, right? 2 by 2, it can be initialized. Or we can just simply, okay, like this first and then try to visualize it first. So 2 by 2 will be like this. So from this, you can see that if you declare matrix 2 by 2, you will get array of 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. The first element will be the number of the row of this matrix. Row 1, row 2. Row 1 index 0, row 2 index 1. And about the column, this one is column 0, column 1 index 0, column 2 index 1. So you can see that this, okay, you have to keep in mind that if you want to refer to the matrix array, right, array of the matrix in C, right, you may have to start from 0 index. Okay, so. And then next, I declare this, like when we execute this, this metric will be offset to 0. So for my suggestion is that you need to initialize all metrics, always initialize all metrics to be 0, right? Okay, so from this, right, if you want to traverse along this matrix, right? We may have to use integer. No, for loop, right? We have to use two loops. For integer I form. Okay, I will define row. Define row 1. Oops. Define column 2. There are two rows and two columns. Okay, the row will be the first index and the column will be the second index. Okay, I form 0 to row. You can write like this and then I plus plus. For me, right, I will write like this. For loop, I this and J loop. J from 0, J to column, and J plus plus. Okay, you can write like this. And then I want to assign matrix I and J, right? Is equal to I plus J. Okay, let's think like this. Row plus column. And then let's see. I 0, J 0. So 0. I 0, J 1. The result is 1. I 0, J 1. The result is 1. I 0 has to change to I 1. J 0. So it will be 1. Right. And 1, 1 will be 2. So this will be the result. I will set this to yourself. So if I change this, so by using define like this, so if I change 2, 3. I want to make it more difficult, a bit more difficult. So I just change define to row 3, column 3. So the result will be printed out the same. You see that we now have the matrix 3 by 3, and then the result inside the matrix element will be addition of the index number. So 2, 2, it will be 4. 1, 2 is 3, something like this. Okay. So if you are going to multiply, sorry, you are going to, okay, let's start with the easiest one, 2 by 2. And then if I want to add two matrix together, integer matrix 1, matrix 2, and matrix 3. Okay. And then we our initialize to be 0. Okay, and then we want to add matrix 1 and matrix 2 to matrix 3. So what shall we do? So we can do the same thing. It's very easy, right? Matrix 3 is equal to matrix 1 plus matrix 2. Am I right? Okay, if I want to initialize matrix 1, I will write like this, right? Comma. So we have two rows, right? And then matrix 1 will be 1, 2, 3, 4. This one will be 5, 6, 7, 8. I can also initialize the matrix of a two-dimensional matrix, okay? And then run. You can see. Initialize, so matrix 1 will be 1, 2, 3, 4. Matrix 2 will be 5, 6, 7, 8, right? And then I want to add them. One plus 5 is 6. 1 plus 5 is 6. And then 2 plus 6 is 8. And 10 and 12. Okay, this is for the matrix addition. Okay, you can also do this for the matrix subtraction. But the more, a bit more difficult, that will be the matrix multiplication. What does it mean by matrix multiplication? The first ij, the result of 0, 0 will be 1 times 5. And 2 plus 2 times 7, right? Chita, what do you mean? Okay, you send icon, so I don't know. Do you follow me? Okay, this is this one. Okay, I will stop for a while at this phase, and then before we will go to the matrix multiplication. For the one who can follow, for the one who can follow this, right, you can go for the matrix multiplication, okay? This is matrix mark. This is matrix addition. I will give the hint that for matrix multiplication, you need to add more root k. For matrix multiplication, it needs to be square matrix. Square matrix. Okay, if I don't want to use this because matrix 2 by 2, the multiplication is just simple like this. Okay, visualization. One, 5, 5 plus 14. 5 plus 14 is Sorry, it did this. So this is supposed to be multiplication. This one is also multiplication. Okay, yes. Five. Okay, 19. Sixteen, 22, yes, and 43, 60, 50. Yes. Okay, you can get the result matrix like this. Okay, that's we have. Okay, you can try to type this and then see the result. And if anyone who can finish this, maybe you can go to solve the problem of matrix 3 by 3. Okay. It's a bit more difficult. And I will have a short break for 10 minutes and then we come back again and start with the function. Okay, come back. Peter and Vid asked me to continue teaching. Okay, let's go. Okay, maybe I will. Okay, I think this one will be the result of the 3x3 matrix. I would like to remind you all here, because of the matrix multiplication, it's not necessary to be the multiplication of the square matrix. But in this example, I just want to make it easier to write a program. But if you want to have okay, because for the matrix multiplication, there are other conditions about the row and column, right? But I'm not going to go into detail about this one. Okay, so I just want to maybe just consider only the square matrix. Okay, and this is the result. For this, you can just simply add one more term, right? Matrix I2 plus multiplied by matrix 2J, right? Okay, this is a result for the 3x3 matrix multiplication. For matrix multiplication is a good example of how to make use of the two-dimensional matrix or two-dimensional array. Okay, so the next topic that I'm going to talk today will be function, right? Okay, function is the way that the C programmer will use for writing a program into a set of functions or many functions. For example, we have void function, right? For main, right? You can write if you want to. Okay, main, you have input, process, and output if you want to subdivide the program into your program into three processes, right? Input, process, output. And then if you want to do this, you have to start with void input, right? Maybe for input, you want to get the input, right? Printf. Enter a number, for example. Maybe you want to double number. Okay, this one, this you can use scanf. Do you remember what is the inside this one, percent sign, what for that, for get the input of double? Percent sign what? Please help me. Percent sign LF, thank you. Okay, and then if you want to, okay, this is as an example of how to make use the function with no return value. So when you run this, okay, this is not possible. Maybe we have to use this. Okay, because for Python tutor, I cannot get input. Okay, and then I run. Scanf, you have to. Input. Include stdio.h. And then run. Okay, enter a number, right? 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 5, 6. Okay, this is just to get input from keyboard, right? Okay, no problem. Okay, this is an example of input, or maybe if you want to, okay, to get the message here, character, star, N E S S A G E. You want to get the message here and then print out. Input, enter a number like this, right? And then, okay, just print message. Print message, right? And then scan. We can also, I like to put this to here and then run like this, right? Input, enter a number, right? And then I run. Printf message. Okay, no problem about this message. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right. Okay, so enter a number like this. But in this case, you can just simply get the input, but you don't get the value. You don't know how to, okay, to get number, right, to main. So in order to do this, maybe you have to, okay, define double. Double input in main program, right? And then I get the input and then put input is equal to input. The same name is not possible. Maybe in only in. Okay, in. And this one I have to change to double. So now this function input will be changed to a function to return value double, right? And once you declare this input function to be double, don't forget to put return num. Yes, to this. So when you want to get the input, right, with this message, and then the result of input, right, will be stored in this input in, right? And then we want to print out printf num. Right, so you are going to use percent sign LF again, right? And then the input is K and then backslash N. Okay, it's num here. Okay, do you get the point? And then I try to run. Not num in. We should have warning format, not a string literal or no format argument. Maybe I have to change this to stop, and this I have to change to this maybe. Okay, the input is 12.34, right? The input is exactly what we want here. So we can use this. I'm not sure whether we have to put this as a constant character, right, to make sure that there is no warning. I'm not sure about this, but there is not only warning, the program is still running. Okay. Okay, the input is like this. So this is the way that we want to get the input. Right, and the result of the input will be assigned into the local variable in main function. Okay, but if we want to change into input two, but I want to, okay, this is a message, right? And I want to get the result like scanf. Do you remember scanf is like this? And insert input okay input one is input two is okay I want to maybe to use input two but I don't want input two to return the value to in so I will use function with no return again input two and then there are two variables two parameter message and double this one is passed by reference right I use num first and then delete num here okay we print the message right and this is void function so you don't have to do that and then scan when you use address num here you have to put this to be star num see this one is a pass by pointer okay this is the second way of getting the input and then return the result into the local variable in here and this one is Amazon this one is asterisk or star and you use this one and then run scan if all none now is already okay you don't have to use this one okay run okay enter number 2 3 4 okay first input print out the correct input one is correct and then 1 2 3 4 5 6 okay 1 2 3 4 5 6 right? These are two different ways of input right this one is pass this function is for return the value double this function is function with no return but this function is you just get you just have the parameter passed by value right, or passed by copy but this one is passed by value or copy and also this one is passed by reference once you get the input into num right the num will be bound to this number and then go back to in and in this is a local variable in main right you'll get the result from input two and then you will get the result and then you can print out the correct result here okay any question so once again in your examination you have to if I asked you to do to perform an operation. Maybe you have to start with input process and output, right? Even I didn't say that you need to get the input from the question statement. Maybe you have to write the input by yourself. Okay, from this I will copy. This one is important. I can say that if I ask you to, okay, to return the value back to main program, right? You need to define it like this, right? Star num, right? So once you have changed any this variable, right, it will impact to the num, right, which is bound with the integer in main, in the main function. Okay, if you change this, right, to get the input from keyboard, this num and num will change the value in int in variable as well. Okay, so in the exam, as I just told you, that we are going to have the pass by value or copy and pass by reference or pointer. You need to know how to pass and get the result back into the main function. Okay, these are three, four things, four kinds of function that you need to know, and can do you have to write the program manually. Okay, so please be careful that you don't have the computer in order to check for your correctness. Maybe you need to know how to debug it. Okay. Do you get the point? Can we come back to Python tutor, right? Because I want to teach you the last one, that is a recursive function. Recursive function is a function that you use for call itself, function itself, right? For this example, if I get the input will be like this. Okay, if I check if num is less than or equal to zero, then I will check the input again. Okay. Okay, this one is to perform the loop to get the input, right? Okay, so if it will continue getting the input right until the input is positive number, right? Okay, maybe you have to make use this one as well. Okay, so I run. Enter number. Okay, if I input zero, okay, it's not okay. So it will, this program will keep trying to ask to get the number, right? Minus one, okay, not, is a valid number, right? 12, okay, if it is a valid number, so it's out from this. So this is a good example of to make use the recursive function in order to get or input the number until the predefined or desired number is received from the keyboard. Okay, so this is one of the recursive function. And for the recursive function, we can also use for writing, for example, factorial input. If I change this to factorial, there are several kinds of recursive function, right? Integer n, okay, and factorial. Return integer. Maybe we have to use long integer, right? And this one we print F percent sign L LD, right? Percent sign LD backslash N. Okay, and then this is a result of factorial. then because we cannot get the result, we choose 10 and it's 10. So in order to write the function factorial, right, you get the parameter number n, right? Please keep in your mind that if you want to write a recursive function, you need two cases at least. The first one is the best case, right? For the best case, you have to check for if num is equal to zero or num. For factorial, right? So zero factorial and one factorial is equal to one. So for this, right, num factorial or zero factorial and one factorial is equal to one. So it will return one. So this is case is okay, but else is return what? Return factorial n minus one multiplied by n or num. Very simple, right? So we have to advance that n factorial is equal to n times n minus one factorial. So you can simply write the function like this. Don't forget to put the ending condition. So when I write program like this, and then when I try to execute this, okay, so it's n is 10. So now 10. You can see that now n is 10, and then when you call factorial, okay, factorial will be extended in stack memory, and then you're trying to find n is equal to num for 10, and 10 is not 0 or 1, so you have to find 9, 8, 7, 6, right? Until you get the value back, and then this is the result of 10 factorial. See? What if I change this to 20? Oh, 20 is the result is very big, right? Can you see this? Okay, so this is a recursive function for factorial. Okay, because the factorial, right, starting from 10 factorial, right, the result is very big. So you need to declare it as long integer. Even for the input number is just integer or short, right? But the result is very big. Okay, this is for factorial. One interesting recursive function is to find greatest common divisor or GCD. Suppose we want to find the greatest common divisor of two things, two number, right? Let's say 45 and 72. What is the greatest common divisor of 45 and 72? D, C, D. You can use Euclid, right? Do you know Euclid? If num is equal to num For finding this, you have to start from bigger one, and 45 is here. If num 2 is equal to 0, return num 1. This is a Euclid. Else, it is GCD of num. One. Num one modulo num two. Have to go back to the previous slide. You can see this slide I will send to you, right? I don't want to share this. Okay, you can see from this. Okay, this is how to find greatest common divisor. Greatest common divisor can be found by, okay, if you get any number A and B, right? That's supposed to be positive number, and low will be min of A and B. Low will be minimum value, high will be maximum value. If low is equal to 0, then return high. If low is equal to 1, then return 1. And else, if else return GCD low, modulo, high, modulo low. Okay? And 74 and 60. So I will continue trying to write like program like this. Share. Come back to this, right? So we have num one and num two, right? Actually, I will just guess that the left hand side is minimum, okay? 45 and 72, and then if low, that is num 1 is equal to 0, then return high, that is num 2. And then else if num 1 is equal to 1, then return 1. And else will return low and num 2 modulo num 1. Okay, so try to find 45 and 72. Next. Okay, we have GCD to find GCD for 45 and 72, and then so we will not meet the two conditions, right? So we will continue. Number one, Return num one and num two modulo num one. So num two modulo num one is 45 and 27. But we may have to change it to the. นี่กำลังสอนหนังสืออยู่ขอโทษตอนโอเค so maybe we have to change a bit to this modulo actually when num to modulo num one right we have to call num to modulo num one and num one Okay, it maybe we have to edit this code a bit. It can guarantee that num one, num two. Okay, I have changed this to num one. Because it can guarantee that now num one is less than num two, but when num two modulo num one, this will be less than num one. So maybe I change this a bit. Okay, then. Next. Okay, now is 27 and 45, and then 18 and 27, and 9 and 18. And then now you can see this. Now it is 0 and 9. When num 1 is equal to 0, so GCD is 9. Okay, print now GCD. Okay, return value back to the result. Result is 9. Okay. This is a shorter version of GCD, right? You have to guarantee that the first element or first parameter is supposed to be the lower or minimum number. Okay, maybe we can also try more. 20 and what? From this is 24 and 16. 16, okay. Twelve and 24, and then 0 and 12, and now so we will reach to this one, so CCD will be 12. 12. Okay, if we cannot find, okay, this one is still easy, maybe 25. Okay, so there is no GCD. GCD is 1, right? So this will be 1 and 24, and then, okay, this is 0. This is num 1 is 1, so you get the result is 1. Okay? Sawani, what's happened? Okay, so this is a recursive function for GCD. This is a recursive function. So I will give you the try to write a function in order to get iterative function for GCD. Okay, iterative function for GCD. Okay. So, I think it is that's all for our class today. Have a good luck. Okay. This is 10 questions for this examination. We will have 10 questions. Please manage your time carefully, right? Because there are 10 questions you need to prepare before the examination. If you are trying to solve the problem in the examination, I don't think it will be okay, right? You will not have enough time to complete it on time. So you have to prepare for the examination. Okay? Thank you very much and have a good luck. It is a paper-based exam for this coming, for next week, 24th of October. Okay? And we are going to have the programming exam as well. Okay?
Okay.